people tonight. Of you, Jesus. Let them know why you came. Let them know why you came, not to be entertained, but Rock City, tell them. And this is why, because he's the only one who understands me. Jesus.
Jesus, it's you. Who understands the language of my tears. The broken parts of me that haven't healed.
Say it again, Jesus, it's you. Say,
Jesus, it's you. Who understands the language of my tears.
Say, God, but you're working.
But you're working on me. You're still working on me.
We were in sound checking. Pastor Mike blessed me. He reminded me of Luke chapter 7. There was a woman. The Bible says she was a sinful woman. It's a prostitute. Pharisees had invited Jesus over to eat, and she heard he was there, and she got there. Pastor shared with us, it says that she didn't say a word, but she walked up and there was tears rolling down her face. She was crying. She couldn't speak, but her tears were speaking for her. And she was at Jesus' feet. Her tears began to drop on his feet. And y'all, I don't know about you, but it's been some moments in my life where the words just couldn't come out just right. That the pain was so deep and it ran back so much history behind while I was crying. I couldn't say something, but he understood what I was saying. And somebody ought to give God praise, because when nobody else understood why he was crying, he said, baby, get over that. Get over it. You don't know what I'm going through. Baby, you don't know what I've been through. And that's why I can say, God, that's what I want you. Because you understand the depths of my heart. Yeah, Jesus is you. I still got some broken parts.
I'm not healed.
One more time, say, Jesus, it's you.
Jesus, it's you.
Woo. Thank you, God.
Who understands the language of my tears.
The broken
parts of me that haven't healed.
So say, all I want is more.
All I want is Jesus.
If you're tired of being misunderstood, just lift your hands and say, all I want is more. Not people's approval. People's acceptance of you.
Jesus.
One more time, God. Say, all I want is more.
All I want is more.
That's it.
Jesus.
Come on, lift your hands. Every hand lifted. Say. Let's say it together. Let's say.
I have everything I need.
Look, because the great I am.
The great I am.
Say the great I am.
The great I am. Provides for me.
Come on, sing that one more time. Say, God, I have everything.
I have everything that I need.
Oh, that sounds so good. Say, God, I have everything.
I have everything that I need.
God has given it to you. I have everything.
I have everything.
Say, because the great I am.
The great I am provides for me.
Say that one more time. The great.
The great I am provides.
If you know his strength is made perfect in your weakness, say, God, you are my strength.
You are my strength when I am.
Anybody besides me ever get weak sometime, but God, you are.
Sure,
come on, say, God, you're my strength.
everything all right. I'm ready, A-Rod. Let's have some fun. Yeah. Clap your hands. Come on.
Oh, How are you, sir?
I'm gonna start
here. So I guess you can always just sit maybe on my left just to start with. I don't know where it is. I'm still asking. Where am I sitting?
You must sit here. That's not the go for thingy. And you brought somebody with you. I got this here. That's it. Let's get me to the
I saw no water. This.
You're gonna bring us now. Just take one with it.
No. No. One, two. A very good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We are about to start in the next 4 minutes at exactly 8 p.m. We would like for the band and the BDs to please preset onto the stage. Three minutes. It is my great pleasure and honor to welcome you all to our very first Jesus Collective Live. Now, this is crazy because about 7 years ago in 2013, when the Jesus Collective was born in a small little town called Ashton, which is about 2 hours away from Cape Town, no one would have thought that today, 7 years in partnership with TBN, as well as with One Gospel, we will be taking the message of grace through music throughout the whole of Africa. And thank you, Lord, for Facebook and YouTube as well, because this message is not only going throughout Africa, but in time, it's going to be out all over the world. As a matter of fact, if you are watching us from Facebook, we've got a Facebook page that is called the Jesus Collective Facebook page, or you're watching us on YouTube, please just let us know where you are and where you're watching this from. Also, let us know what God is saying to you and is doing in your life throughout this broadcast. And so for me, it is my honor and my pleasure to welcome the Jesus Collective, led by the founder, Mr. Hilton Peterson.
Thank you, Loy. Thank you, Loyiso. Can we just stand? I think there was a... There's been a request from the president that we just said, honor the people that lost their lives through COVID. And we're wearing black just to represent and to honor those people, the victims, people that lost their life through COVID. So if you can just have a minute of silence. Power heads. Thank you. So who of you is excited to be here tonight? Who of you are excited to be here tonight? We are here and we're going to lift up the name of Jesus. We are going to break certain things. I said we're going to break certain things that needs to be broken, because he's still majestic. He is still powerful and he's still almighty. He's not in a corner. He's not in a corner. He is still God. And he's alive and well. It might have been rough, but always in the middle of a storm is always opportunities. In the middle of the storm is always order. So Father, we thank you tonight. That is demons who's in you, Father. We give you tonight all the glory of our Father. We bring this service, we bring this enactment, and we bring it before your throne tonight, Father. Nothing of us, Abba Father, everything of you, Abba Father. Tonight, Abba Father, we come into your throne. We come humbly before your throne, Father. In a time of need, Father, we come before your throne, Abba Father. It has not been the easiest year, Father. But we know, Abba Father, that you are God, Abba Father. That you alone reign, Abba Father. That you alone are mighty, O God. And so tonight, Father, we ask you, Father, that this voice in this room, that this will transcend to any home and every house, Abba Father, in Africa around. Father, on the fire, on the YouTube, that it will go all around the world, O God. And we will let this enemy know that our God is alive. We're not going to depend on scientists, but tonight we shout the name of Jesus.
for deliverance. We are in need of you, O God. And so tonight, we thank you. We worship you. We glorify your name. We serve no foreign God. We serve Yahweh. We serve the Creator of heavens and the earth, O God. So Father, tonight, you are still our Master. You are still our Savior. You are still our healer. You are still our deliverer. Father, we thank you. We are in no comparison. We work whatever ever you have put in our hands to work with. So Father, we pray tonight when every minstrel come onto the stage, when they take the mic and release the sound, those tonight that find themselves in hospitals, those tonight that find themselves fighting this pandemic, Father, I ask you, dear Jesus, Father, I ask you, humbly before your throne, I serve a God that is well. I serve a God that answers prayers. Prayers is not a wishless. It is my weapon. So, Father, tonight I pick up my weapon, which is prayer. Father, tonight I pick up my weapon. And I ask you tonight, Father, when the sound goes, Father, tonight there's a lot of lights and everything looks excellent. But the ultimate light should be us. Father, your words of Matthew 5. Don't hide it, but lift it up. Put it on the hill for everyone to see. Father, tonight, I ask you that you will come and you will do great works. Here, Jesus, we serve you. We love you. So tonight, we ask you humbly before your throne. We are here shaking your face. And we ask you that tonight through music, that you, as the saint was sworn, that you will lift the evil spirit. Father, tonight, we ask you, like was sworn, David just made music. He just played his harp. And Father, tonight, I ask you, that while we make music, that lives will be transformed, that those who are lost will run to you and let you know that they need you. Father, while we make music, that those who are watching tonight and are in hospital beds, or maybe in their lounge, or maybe in the street, or maybe in their church, that tonight is the night, because you are about to restore, you are about to rebuild, and you are about to repair. So Father, come on, Father, we thank you. Lift up the name of Jesus. Lift up the name of Jesus like never before. Lift the name up. That's the God that we serve. One that answers prayers. Lift it up. Lift it up. Lift it up. Lift it up.
Worthy. the world with your hands lifted, say, we give you.
Jesus. vrede klokke in jou hart wil kry. En die soete vrede wat by jou sal bly. Wanneer loop die smalle weg, hier vir Christus aandag weg, dan lei hy die vrede klokke in jou hart.
anointed. Let me hear a hallelujah in this place. Hey.
Yeah.
Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, the fight is over. Let me hear you. The battle is lost, the fight is over. The victory has been won, the fight is over. Let me hear you. The victory has been won, the fight is over. So rejoice and be glad, the fight is over. Everybody, la 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 la, say la 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 la, say la la la, oh la 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 la, say la 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 la, oh la 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 la, say la 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 la. Now you know it. Let me sing a little bit higher. Let's go.
The battle is the Lord's, the fight is over.
Everybody, let me hear.
The battle is the Lord's, the fight is over.
Victory has been won.
Victory has been won.
song.
What a mighty God we serve.
Everybody in the building say,
what a mighty God we serve.
The angels bow before Him.
The angels bow before Him. Heaven and earth adore Him. What a mighty God we serve.
Let me hear you in the building say, count of three, we're all gonna shout, the fight is over. One, two, three, shout!
worship you tonight for who you are, beyond what you've done. We give you all the glory, King Jesus. We bless your holy name. We worship you, Father. Give you all the glory, Jesus.
Darkness, my God, that is who.
pandemic, we've seen you. When man said it was over, you said it's beginning. You brought springs in the desert. Where there was no way, you made a way. Food on the table, water to drink, healing for our soul. We didn't lose our minds because you were good. You've kept us. 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 We're giving glory. We're giving glory. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Back to you and me,
I worship.
soul's joy to worship you here. It's our safety in your worship place. It's our safety at your feet. Right where you are seated, as we marvel at your beauty, as we feast upon your glory, and as we sing the song of angels. Every tongue confess, every knee will bow. Every tongue confess, He is Lord. Christ is Lord. He is Lord. Jesus Christ is Lord. Every knee will bow. Every knee.
Every knee will bow.
Every tongue will confess. Yes.
Jesus,
every knee
Bow right now in the name of Jesus. Lord, oh Lord, thou Lord and Savior is our Lord and Savior. He's our Lord and Savior. We've been honored, saints, in the name of Jesus, that the kingdom of all kings resides in us. The kingdom of all. He resides in us, the Lord above all, Lord. Oh, la, 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 la.
bow and every tongue will confess that He is Lord. Isn't it amazing that God always calls Himself according to your need? If you are sick, you can call out to Jehovah Rapha, the healer. He doesn't say, I heal. He says, my name is healer. If you have lack in your life, He calls Himself the solution to your problem. He says, I am Al Shaddai. I am God of more than enough. He's not the God of more than enough. He is God of more than enough. If you are struggling and you cannot find, you're in a place of turmoil, He says, I am Shalom. My name is Shalom. And that is why when Moses said, who shall I say you are? Not to Pharaoh, but to the Israelites. Who shall I say you are? He says, when you get there, you better say the following. I am. Because He is your present help in your time of need. Whatever you need, He is. Not that He has it, He is. In other words, you may not know what it is that you need, but in the presence of God, your need will be met. That's why all we are ever about is the presence of God. Because in the presence of God, there is fullness of joy. In the presence of God, there is fullness of joy. And once you know who He is, you are able to call out to Him, because God is not going to just arrive in your life and start becoming everything that you need. You're going to have to call out His name. You're going to have to start saying Jesus. You're going to have to start calling out Rapha if you need healing. You're going to have to start calling out Jehovah Nisi if you need protection. Because God will never force Himself on you. And you know what the wonderful thing is? He doesn't wait for you to come to Him. He comes to you, and then He waits for you to open the door. He came all the way from heaven, came to this earth, lived the life that you couldn't live, died the death that you should have died, so that He could rise from the dead and set you free. He has already paid the price for you. And all He needs now is for you to meet Him. But how does this happen? The book of Romans chapter 10 verse 9. It says this. Declare with your mouth that Jesus Christ is Lord, and believe in your heart that God raised Him from the dead, and you shall be saved. Just call out my name. Just call out my name. But God has come today to introduce Himself to you. And all you have to do is to say that you are Lord. That's the first name that you need to call Him by. Lord. And then you believe in your heart that God raised Him from the dead. Because you cannot call Him Lord, but then still think that you're going to have to do everything that you have to do in order to receive redemption. We were slaves to sin, and now we are slaves to righteousness. Don't look at the word slave. We were slaves to sin, and now we are slaves to righteousness, which is freedom. A friend of mine always says, and he reminds me of this, he says, a slave cannot set himself free or herself free. It doesn't matter how well you work for your master. you will never be free. You cannot work your way out of that. If you needed to be free, somebody had to come from the outside who was not a slave and pay a price for you in order to redeem you, because you cannot redeem yourself. And so that's why the Son of Man was not born of the same seed that you and I are born with. He was born of a virgin birth. It was the incorruptible seed, so that he who's from outside could pay the price with his blood and redeem you and set you free. Jesus has set me free. And all we want is to give you the exact same gift that we got. We haven't come here for something, but we are here to give you something. To introduce you to the Lord who sets people free. And so if you are there right now, and if that is you that I'm speaking to, even if you are in this room, it is very simple. Declare with your mouth that he's Lord and believe that God raised him from the dead. And you shall be saved. And trust you me, the life of him or her who has been set free is not the same as the one who is in bondage. Your life will never be the same again. He will be your Lord. He will walk with you. He will fight your battles. And you will live in utter freedom. As a matter of fact, the Bible says that the enemy comes to kill, steal, and destroy. And then Jesus says, but I came that you may have life, and life in abundantly. That is life that overflows. This Father that you are going to be meeting today, he does not give you gifts because Christmas is coming around. He does not give you gifts like me as a father are going to be able to give to my children. Because he will give you peace in the midst of a storm. I don't know what shop right now sells peace. He will give you joy. He'll package it up. He'll give it to you, and you will have joy, guaranteed. And that is what we need right now. Because it may be a while before it is over. But I know that God can give you what you need in order to get through it. And so if you are there, I'm going to ask you just to say this prayer after me. And we're going to believe that as of today, the slave to sin has passed and the free man in Christ has risen. We're going to believe together with you. And so maybe you want to close your eyes, or you just want to look at the screen if you're watching this over TBN, over One Gospel, Facebook, YouTube, or even if you're here at Hillsong with us today. Let us pray with you and introduce you to Jesus, the name above every other name. Say, Lord Jesus, thank you for speaking to me. I believe that you are Lord, that you are God the Son, who died for me, was raised from the dead, so that I could be set free. I now receive freedom. I now receive you as my Lord and Savior. Make me new. Make me whole. I thank you for transforming my life, body, soul, and spirit. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, guys. Let's give them a round of applause. Welcome to the family. If you, maybe you're watching on Facebook and you have received Christ today as your Lord and Savior, please just go on and just comment and say, I have received. We want to celebrate with you, and I'm sure there are many people who are going to know who you are. If you know someone who's received Christ today, please reach out to them. join together with them and find a Bible-believing church. Join it and get together with all your saints. We're going to carry on worshiping today. And if it ends, we'll still be carrying on. Just find the platform where we are. I'm so grateful for what God has done in my life this year. You know, when I speak about a Savior, He has proven Himself to be exactly just that. And it began, I remember we had a campus, the Jesus Collective, earlier on in the year. And we began to thank God for what He was going to do. You know, your thankfulness is a prophecy to your future. When you say thank you, Jesus, and you're in turmoil, you're actually prophesying to your future. And that's what we did in the beginning of the year. Thanksgiving. Thanksgiving. It is a sacrifice unto God. And so whatever God has done for you right now, just begin to take it. Whatever you thank God for, and believe me, God always gives you something to thank Him for. And just begin to offer it to Him as a sacrifice. As we sing the song, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for what you have been at this time. I call you first, I call you last. I call you everything that you are. You are the one who gives to all more than we could ever ask. You are love, beautiful love that never fails me. You restore all things to you, perfect and true. That's why I sing a thank you, Jesus, for your love. Si abonga, si abonga. You're so
for your love. Siyabonga. Siyam. Come on, begin to thank him today for what he has done for you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, G, for your love. Siyabonga. Father, we thank you for what you've done. Siyabonga. Thank you, Jesus. So thank you, Jesus, for your love. Siyabonga.
Comes from the blood.
In the
redemption in the blood. There's healing in the blood. Oh, oh, oh. Sickness bow when we plead the blood. COVID bows when we plead the blood. Every sickness bow when we plead the blood of Jesus. Corona bows when we need the blood.
Dearest Father, close.
most beautiful, most beautiful. Everybody say yeah.
Dearest Father,
closest friend,
closest friend,
most beautiful.
There's
nobody like you.
Most beautiful.
Dearest Father,
dearest Father,
closest friend, yes,
closest friend,
most beautiful,
most beautiful,
most beautiful,
most beautiful.
Come on, just raise it one more time in the room and just say it. Dearest Father,
dearest Father,
closest friend, most beautiful.
Yeah. bend your wrist one day in your court. Then a thousand days elsewhere. Bend your wrist one day in your court. Bend your wrist one day in your house. Bend your wrist one day in your court. Then a thousand elsewhere.
Hallelujah. Come on, put your hands together. Come on, open up your mouth and give the Lord the fruit of your lips. Come on, he deserves the praise. For great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. I said, for great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. He don't need our praise, but he deserves it. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. He's worthy to be praised. Come on, if it's the lifter of your head, just begin to lift your hands and say, God, you are the lifter. Look at somebody and say, he's the lifter of my head. From whence cometh your help.
Oh.
wheel in the middle of the wheel. You're a doctor in the sick room. You're a lawyer in the courtroom. You are my way in, and you are my way over. You are my way in, and you brought me over.
Hey,
and you brought me over.
Tell us,
and you brought.
Shield me when I
Did you enjoy yourself? We have come to the end. Amen. And you are happy to go home? Voel je gemakkelijk om huis toe te gaan? It is 10:30 in the evening. We are ready to go home. One more. The left hand.
Come on up. All right. Whoa. Say.
There's one more. Yo.
Father, thank you for keeping in my perfect mind. You're the lifter. Never left me, never forsaken me. You're the lifter. Oh, my. Yeah. For keeping me in my perfect peace, you're the lifter. Why would I be without you, God? You're the lifter.
You're the lifter of our heads, Father. No matter what we face, no matter what storms we are in, you remain the lifter of our heads, oh God. No matter what we face, no matter what the situation in our lives, you remain the lifter of our heads, Father. You give us strength where there is weakness. You give us provision where there is lack. You give us healing where there is sickness. You remain the lifter, Father. You the one that might open up our eyes in the morning. You the one that give us the breath to breathe. You are the one that makes us to calculate the day and the nights. You alone are the one, Father, we thank you. Because there is none like you, Father. Father, I know, Father, everyone is telling us that the COVID is supposed to rise, Father. But you are the lifter. Father, we thank you. Here, thank you, Here. Here, give all the lof. And give all the praise, Here. But there is no one like you, Here. You give us the strength. You give us, Here, the weltoeligheid. Here, you ondersteun us. Here, you lift us up, Here. Father, you take us from muddy clay, Father. And you make us, Father, most expensive wine. Father, you take stinking water. You make it the best wine ever. But only thing that we need to do, Father, is to believe, Father, that you have sent your Son to the cross for our sins and our iniquities. You sent your Son.
because we are not perfect, but we know we have been chosen. We are unworthy, but we know we have been forgiven. Everything we have and everything we own runs from a fountain of unending grace. So Father, you alone, oh God, you alone are the lifter of our heads, oh God. Yes, they will speak about you. Yes, they will talk about you. But he remains the lifter of your head. Yes, they will say all kinds of things. Yes, we have lost loved ones. Yes, we have lost friends. Yes, we have lost people. Yes, we have lost our stuff. But he remains the lifter. He remains the lifter. He alone are worthy to be praised. I tell you that this God that I serve, he's going to deal with this issue. He's going to take the baton and he's going to show the enemy. Whatever he's trying to do, he will raise up a remnant. He will raise up a remnant in the end time. He is coming back. There's no time to play around, not to love one another, because he is coming back. He is coming back for you and I. When we die, we go to heaven. But Jesus, his responsibility is to look after us, is to pray for us, is to intercede for us. That is Jesus's responsibility about my life, about my family's life, about your family's life. He's supposed to intercede for you. So he's seated at the right hand of the Father, looking down tonight, and he's saying, look how my children, look how my precious seed is worshiping me. So whatever they ask in my name, Father, I ask, if it is healing, give them the healing. If it's a house, give them the house. If it's a car, give them the car. If it is a job, give them a job. What is your praise that will get his attention? It is your worship that will get him to move on your behalf. Don't play around. The end time is near. Jesus is coming back. There's no time. He says, love one another. Love one another. And help one another. But keep the firm grip of the promises that I have given you. And I ask you tonight, keep a firm grip on the promises that God has given you. When you were 14, when you were 15, when you were 16, when you were 19, when you were 20. Because the suffering of the present time, it's like small potatoes. It can never be compared to the things that God is in store for you. Listen here. Eyes have not seen. Ears have not heard. It has not come up into the hearts of men what God has in store for you and I. Listen here. He says, I will level out the mountains, give you the treasures of darkness, and give you the riches of secret places, riches that the enemy is not aware of, treasures that the enemy is not aware of. But it's our responsibility to love, to serve, to honor, to give. It is our responsibility to believe that he is the King of Kings, that he is the Lord of Lords. It is our responsibility to know that we serve a living God. It is our responsibility.
So Father, we thank you. We pray this prayer by faith, believing that we've received everything. We will never be silent, Father. No matter what comes our way, we will always worship you. Because we believe that you are a way maker, a promise keeper. And so today we give you all the glory, we give you all the honor. Thank you for the lives that's been changed. Thank you for the lives that's been touched. And we give you tonight all the glory, we give you the honor. Thank you, Father, for keeping us. Thank you for keeping our families. It hasn't been an easy year, Father, but you remain on the throne. And so, Father, we are grateful tonight. We are so honored to be in your presence. We know that you are about to do a great work. 3 years ago, we started off, Father, with signs, wonders, and miracles. And the year after that, Father, it was evidence, witness, and overflow. Father, 2021 will be the year of repair. It will be the year of rebuild. And it will be the year of restoration. So, Here, ons dank Here for the restoration that's coming. Whatever afgebreek is, Here, gaan U weer opbou. Father, we thank you. We give you all the glory because there is none of you, Father. Ek is nie bang om nog aan te bid nie. Ek is nie bang, ek raak hierdie moeg nie. Want ek weet, wat ek vanavond my Here vra, gee vir my oor 'n weekend. Ek weet nie van jou af nie. But I simply be God. I simply God. That took somebody from Esther, living in a small set, and he gave me this vision. So I know what I'm talking about. This God that I serve, he's no respecter of person. What he does for one, he can do for others. But we need to believe. This God that I serve gave me everything over a weekend. But I never stopped. I never considered my circumstances. I never considered the circumstances of my environment. I believe. Thank you, Father. Hebrews 10 says, let's do this. Let us do this. Be confident. Be confident and represent God in the inside and on the outside. In the inside and on the outside. He says, keep a firm grip on the promises he has given you. Because that will keep you going. Nothing else. The enemy only attacks your promises. But then the scripture after that is the one that breaks my heart. In meaning joy. He says, Jesus, God, will always keep his word. You must just keep a firm grip. No matter how it looks. Tell him every day, Father, you promised me this. And I will give it to you, pressed down, shaken together, run it over. When Jesus descended, Loyiso, the first thing he rebuked, or the thing that he rebuked the whole Matthew 29 or 28, was the belief. And so little things has happened in your life that you stop believing. I will never. I'd rather believe to find out that side there is nothing. But not believe here, and you get there, and there's something. I don't let anybody misrepresent God to me. He's gracious. He's forgiving. Doesn't punish. His grace is abounding. But we need to make right decisions.
whatever you ask in his name, Mark 11, that he will give. So in whose name are you asking? For what reason are you asking? Because he says, if you delight yourself in me, I give you the desires in your heart. The reason why the desires doesn't come to fulfillment, because it's your own desires. And you are not delighting yourself in him. Delight yourself in him. He plants the desires. Then that desire never fails. Ik moet gaan. Loyiso speaks longer than me, but I have to go. Faith is the substance of things hoped for. Stop near that. Romans 5 verse 3 says, suffering, perseverance, endurance. Now endurance builds your character. Now your character, says the word, produce hope. That's the hope in faith. You have to suffer. You have to endure. You have to persevere. Your character needs to build. Now when you get faith in the substance of things hoped for, you have suffered, you've endured, your character is built, and then you see the evidence of things not seen. If he's promised you a house, doesn't mean you must now imagine yourself a house. The evidence is of the small things that you've seen him doing all along. That's the evidence. But now you hope for the car, and now you don't get the car, now you get discouraged. He says, it's the faith of substance you hope for, the evidence of things not seen. So you have the evidence of the small things that God has done. But you have to suffer. Don't walk away from suffering. Mensen moet uit jou lewe uitloop. Listen to me. Because Jairus, before he got to the miracle, Jesus removed him. Then the miracle took place. Vader, ons dankie vir die aand wat jy ons gegee het. Daar is niemand soos u nie. You alone are worthy, Father. You alone are mighty. You alone, Father, are the Savior. Once again, we give you all the glory. We give you all the honor. Nothing of us and everything of you. This year, Father, we know that you are busy doing something in the earth. Father, we speak and we stand tonight in thanksgiving, giving you thanks for what you're about to do. And we thank you. Thank you for protecting us. Thank you for preserving us. Thank you for the invisible security all around us. Thank you, Father, for keeping us safe. Thank you, Father, for keeping us from harm. Thank you, Father, for keeping the devourer away on our behalf, Abba Father. I pray that you will continue to connect us with people that will take us through a roof down and lower us down to Jesus for a miracle. That you will not surround us with people that will kill dream killers, but you will surround us with people like the four men that will lift us up through a roof, go through all the Everest to balance us down to Jesus. Surround us with people that will always balance us to our victory. So, Father, we give you all the glory. We pray that you will continue to bless every person connected and working with Jesus Collective. Thank you, Father, for the intercessors. Thank you, Father, for everyone that take their time to fast and pray, oh God. Thank you, Father, for everything. Thank you, Father, once again for TBN. Thank you, Father, for One Gospel. Thank you, Father, for everyone that has a part in this production. Father, I pray that 2021, Father, will be a year, Father, that there will be repair, rebuild, and restoration, oh God. I pray that these stations, Father, that things will just come their way, Abba, Father. They don't even have to go ask, but people will just sow into their vision, oh God. Bless them. Bless their families of the decision makers, Abba, Father. Everyone that works at TBN, everyone that works at One Gospel, I ask that you will bless them. Everyone that came in here tonight, Father, I pray everyone came here with different needs and different situations. I know, Father, that you are God, Abba, Father, that can turn things around while they worship in this room tonight. Thank you, Father, for those who are there and watching us, Father, over the cyberspace, over YouTube and Facebook. I pray that you will continue to give them the desires of their hearts, that you will open up windows in heavens beyond their training and beyond their education. I pray, Abba, Father, that you will connect them with people that will lift them up. For those who are sick in their bodies, Father, I pray that there will be a report of healing coming back. I pray, Abba, Father, we deal whatever, Father, with we, whatever we ask you, Father, tonight in your name. I pray that you will give it unto us. that no word, Abba Father, that's been uttered here today will return void, oh God. Thank you, Father, for being the lifter. Thank you for being our God. Thank you, Father, for being our way maker, promise keeper, in Yeshua's mighty name. And we all say, amen and amen.
Try.